And I'm going to demonstrate IV start for you today. I first want to start with a few tips and tricks before I get into the skill. First of all, I think it's a good idea to try to find the vein that you want to use when you first come into the room, because then you know which side of the bed to set your supplies up on. So I like to just get out my tourniquet, open my package, and just carefully get the tourniquet out without touching anything else. Ask the patient if they have a good vein, if they're right-handed or left-handed. Decide what you need your IV for and make your decision on which vein you want to use. So we'll say that I already did that and I found the vein on the right arm. Then I'm ready to go. If you're having trouble finding a vein, sometimes having the patient dangle their arm off of the bed for a while will really help the blood flow go down into the arm. So that's helpful. You can also wrap the arm in warm blankets and try to get a little more blood flow that way. The other thing that I wanted to mention before I start is that you have a couple of options with your extension tubing. So we're going to be priming an extension tubing and attaching it to the IV. And there's a little cap that has to be removed before we can do that. So one option is to prime your tubing and set it down. And then when it comes time to use it, your one hand, your dominant hand, is probably going to be occluding a vein. And so you might have to remove this cap with one hand, which is actually really difficult to do without contaminating it. So I just wanted to show you that is an option, but that's not the way I'm going to demonstrate it. So you come into the room, you do all the preliminary things, which are not actually on your rubric, but you know that you would identify your patient. And we've already found our vein. And I've educated the patient as to why she needs to have the IV today. So if I haven't already performed hand hygiene, make sure we do that and put on some gloves. You probably are gonna wanna set up your supplies. I like to set the tape aside. I don't use the gauze, so I'm gonna set that aside. As far as the tegaderm goes, if you just bend down the plastic backing a little bit, it gives a good lip for you to grab. You can open up your needle, make sure it's ready to go. And then the last thing is to prime the extension tubing. So when you get the extension tubing out of the package, just make sure that you don't touch the clave. You need to keep that as sterile as possible. And then you're going to open up a flush and keep that end as sterile as possible. If it's a brand new flush, just pull back a little bit to break the seal. And then push the air out, attach the flush to the clave, and then prime your extension tubing. At this point, I like to take off this cap because I don't want to mess with it later. And I'll just set it inside my package here so that I can guarantee that it stays clean. Okay, so now it's time to put the tourniquet on the patient. I always do a little test pull to make sure I have good integrity. And you want to place the tourniquet at least several inches above the site. After you place the tourniquet, give it a minute for the vein to fill up. Like a stroking of the vein is acceptable, but you don't want to hit it like that. Get out your ChloraPrep. Squeeze the little wings to crack it, and then just cleanse the site right over the vein, back and forth. Cover the whole area where your tegaderm is gonna sit because you wanna get all of the oils off of the skin. So back and forth, both directions for 30 seconds. And then you wanna allow it to air dry, and that's when it's seeping down through the layers of the skin and killing bacteria. So that part is really critical. Keeping in mind that you only have 2 minutes to leave your tourniquet on. This is a good time to just talk with the patient or get out your needle and just take a look at your needle and make sure that the catheter doesn't look sheared and everything looks fine. Okay, once you've let your skin dry for 30 seconds, you're ready to start the IV. You can hold it with your thumb and your pointer finger or with your thumb and your middle finger and use your pointer finger to thread the catheter. Either way is a good technique. So I'm left-handed, so I'm gonna try to get at a good angle for you here. I use these three fingers to stabilize my hand. Go right above the vein at an angle appropriate to the depth of the vein, bevel up, poke just a little bit until you kind of feel a give, you kind of feel the needle enter the vein and you'll see a flashback. Then drop the angle a little bit more so you don't go all the way through the vein. Advance just a little bit so that you get the entire catheter inside of the vein. Then thread the catheter forward. I like to do a two-handed method. So I'm just gonna thread the catheter with my right hand. And you wanna thread it all the way up until the hub reaches the skin. At this point, you can release the tourniquet. If you're using a needle that is not shielded, that doesn't have a one-way valve, you're gonna need to occlude about where the end of the catheter would be. Then push the white button to release the needle. Get your extension, attach it to the hub, and tighten your connection. All without touching the site. Make sure you don't contaminate the site. Then flush, looking for any infiltration or resistance. And once you have a good flush, I'd like to keep a hand on the IV start. Peel back the tegaderm and then place the tegaderm so that your sight is in view in the middle of the window. Peel off the paper part of the tegaderm. You can write your initials, the date. This says gauge. You don't need to write the gauge because we all know what gauge it is by the color of the hub. And then just place the label to the side, not covering the site. And then you can tape down your IV further. I recommend not leaving a really long loop right here because that can get caught on things and might pull your IV out. But that is IV start, and then you would clean up your supplies.